makes it all the way to the six. They're able to convert on third down to that. Sets up a first and goal. How about the start throwing the... Football, 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Bo Scarborough, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Patriots drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Taylor will bring the Bills up first and 10 at their own 27. Now it's Taylor. And they didn't wait long to take a shot there, that's for sure. But it falls incomplete, and it's second down. Will tie the intended receiver, and it's second down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid 3 and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
On the left side, a catch by White. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Now a play fake here on first down. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Dante Hightower in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. Stepping up, he'll try and run. Excellent work that time to get free, and for his exploits, he's going to be left with just a 3rd and 3. I thought they were going to sack him there like they did on first down. Great coverage, but he found a way to move with his legs.
Yeah, his ability to take off, not only did he get some yardage back, he got a little bit extra. Really helps him on third down, makes it manageable now.
Throwing the out route incomplete. It's White. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big.
Chances are good he's going to be a very busy guy. Two catches already in this opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that that could be a really, really frequent combination. Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Here's Taylor. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Taylor able to use those legs of his to pick up a first.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
And he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. On second down, Taylor. This is Coleman with the grab. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. His first catch, good for 8 and a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
On first down, they'll run it on the draw play. And power running here down to the 6-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3. On second down, here's Taylor. They still can't. And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo. Tyrod Taylor, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it's capped off by a touchdown run of 6 yards. On the return, here's a dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Brady and the Patriots now first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
20.
They'll start things on first down with Bo Scarborough. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. They face a 2nd and 7 to start things out.
20.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Michelle. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting 3rd and about 4 to go.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And able to find Conley. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
This is Scarborough. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be
scenes, and you pile up statistics.
Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
He's going to float this one deep. This is caught at the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown. New England. Chris Conley, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Pats able to cash in for 6. Now Bullock to add the extra point. Bullock good on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Bullock out now to kick this one away. Now White on the return. And he's able to get it up close to the 35, but hang on here. Penalty marker down. And this one might be going the other way.
Return team.
So that will push him back.
First down.
And now we know why had a little extra space to run, don't we? The legal block in the back, that penalty will move them back.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. They go play action here on first down. He's going to go for a big play. He's got a man complete. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now Taylor. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that is caught. Touchdown, Buffalo. Will tie his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game.
That's almost just not right. You cover everybody. But those tight ends, they can be awfully reliable.
Very reliable. Defense just has to hate those guys.
This drives them crazy because oftentimes you can't match up with them. They have you either with size, speed, or maybe even just strength.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes heading back out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. As we take a look at the playoff picture, and certainly a lot of jostling still to go in these final few weeks. For the moment, they would be a wild card team, far from locked up, but that's why this is exciting. These last few weeks, a lot to play for.
Yeah, exciting for us because we get to talk about it, and, you know, at the end of the day, six teams are going to go from each conference, and guess what? We're going to have a playoff. But nerve-wracking for all the people involved, all the teams, because their goal is to get there. And anything less than that makes the season a disappointment. So listen, they're going to be primed now for a big finish to their season.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. He came out ready to play. That's three tackles for a loss, Charles. We're only in the second quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. Might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They run. This is Scarborough. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. They chalk that one up as a gain of 34 on third down.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Now they'll run it with Scarborough, and he won't get much. Maybe a couple down inside the 35 to the 34.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
White 20! Yeah!
Play action. Now it's Brady. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And caught by Thomas. Touchdown, New England. Michael Thomas, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Patriots have moved out in front. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
On the return, here's White. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. And now out come the Bills. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Throwing now, Taylor on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back to Buffalo after this. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
On the right side, this is Austin with a catch. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Bills passing game, getting him down the field. They've got another first down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
And they'll run it here. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Taylor. And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo. Tyrod Taylor on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today it's track shoes, because that's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far, and fun to watch. And now out come the Patriots. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
False start, offense.
Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
Shotgun now for Brady. And a dump off to White. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Give him 3 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and 12.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And he'll get that to Michelle, complete. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. New England on third down. Can't be any better than a perfect 6-for-6. This will be third and 6. Operating from the gun, Brady. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Now it's Taylor. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Off the play fake, here's Taylor. He'll rifle this one deep right side, and that's caught inside the 35. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. On first and 10, it's Taylor. That is caught at the 7. Now a signal and a timeout call, as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Tavon Austin in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bills have broken the tie. So they're able to break the tie just before halftime. Now they just don't want anything crazy to happen on the ensuing kickoff.
Yeah, they want to just add the extra point, get the kickoff taken care of, and get to the locker room with the lead that they fought so hard to get.
That's fielded in the end zone. And now running right through it. So we've reached halftime. Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? That'll be taken in the end zone. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call.
Hang on, lock in the back. Return team.
This is going to put them back in not great field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return. Then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
And a loose football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Goes underneath here to White. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they...
And this is taken in by Mitchell for a Patriot touchdown. Malcolm Mitchell, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again.
I think he's still shaking his head a little. It was his fumble on the previous drive that led to the touchdown that has us tied.
And sometimes it's worse on a runner who drops it like that to watch the other team take the ball downfield and score than maybe if they just returned it right away. You know what I mean? Because sometimes what happens that fast, you're right back out on the field. Instead, he had to watch it happen. Let's see if it affects him going forward the rest of the game. I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
Here's Taylor to throw. Let's it go for Nelson. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated. Looks for Nelson, and it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off, and he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
They'll try to get this offense going with Michelle. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
On second down, Michelle. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now Brady, he'll check this one down to Michelle. Oh, and the big play's going to get even bigger. His penalty flags are down, and I believe they're going to get a face mask penalty tacked on.
Foul. Face mask. Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
They'll run forward with Bill Scarborough. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Now they'll throw with Brady. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
And when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
They'll run. This is right. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. James White, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Pats take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Extra point up and good by Bullock. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Bullock out now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And the Bills getting set to go. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Play action. Now Taylor. Hits his target. The tight end will tie. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Now Taylor with a draw to McCoy. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Now Taylor to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 39 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. The Bills passing game, getting them down the field. They've got another first down. Well, this is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when and told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football. Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits, and those creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Here's Taylor, and it's caught, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Kelvin Benjamin, his second touchdown on the season, and the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game.
getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss because that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. On the NFL scoreboard, they are in the third now in New Orleans. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. Brady going to throw. Over the middle, that's taken in by Gronkowski. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Back now in Buffalo. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Now Scarborough, and able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Up to make the play defensively, Tre'Davious White.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Now a play fake, Brady. And incomplete there, a nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Here's Brady. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. That'll put him over 150 yards receiving now. Quite a ball game and a first down. Brady now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10.
20, 20, 20.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Left side, that's caught by Mitchell. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 18. He's at the 50. The 30. Past the 20. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. In a tie game, 4th quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations the type of plays they like to run, read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Patriot offense heading back out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. And it's right about this time of year you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go, but still plenty to be determined.
And I think for most teams, the obvious is to try and be the number 1 or number 2 seed.
But when you look at it across the league and throughout the history of trying to get to the Super Bowl, the teams you really fear are the ones that get hot and sometimes sneak in at a 5 or a 6 seed, because we've seen those teams actually get to the Super Bowl and occasionally win it.
Yeah, you think of the Giants a couple of times. Steelers have done it. You're right. It has happened and will happen more in the future, I'm sure. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Here's Brady to throw. Over the middle, the catch made by Mitchell. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. Three plays, three pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like the lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal, expect them to attack right here on this play.
And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with second and goal coming up.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. This is 3rd and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game. He can run for it, and he will. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a 4th down.
Brandon, it's easy to make decisions from right up here where we are, right in the cheap seats, but let's be frank about this one. This isn't even a decision as far as I'm concerned. They have to go for it here. Field goal does you almost no good as time's running out in the game. If you want to win, you have to be aggressive here.
Now Brady, got to have this one. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Gronkowski, the intended receiver. Agreed, that's twice now in this 4th quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
Now a first carry for their fullback. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Taylor. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Now this is a big 3rd down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. That's into the hands of Gallup over the middle. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And a nice run to get this up over the 20-yard line. Now the Patriots will use the 2nd of their timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. So they come up on 2nd down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. They'll keep it on the ground with McCoy this time. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down.
Go down, go down.
And they'll indeed take a knee. The Bills on their way to victory now as they take the knee. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Taylor to a knee, and that ought to just about do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Bills, they remain in the hunt for a first-round bye as they move to 11-3 on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the New York Giants. Meanwhile, for New England, their playoff hopes take a hit as they drop to 7-7. And they'll try again next week at home against Philadelphia. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you set right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero Dale, get my baby 30 for a handbag like Saint Laurent, baby. Real love that money, baby. 100,000 plus 100,000 my whip. Got 30,000 plus 30,000 my wrist. We got it. Those bad bitches. I swear, baby, we just kissing. That's it. How could I forget that you done done for me? Baby, gonna take the charge and take the fall for me. Take you shopping, but girl, I'm in your tone. Sorry, little mama, I can give you more. Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent right now. Could you? I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero Dale, get my baby 35.
Gotta hit him on the jack. When you coming back, where's you at on the mat? Everything is intact. Could've been a seamstress, still wouldn't cut him slack. Pretty much ain't got a clue. Itty bitty piggyback off everything I do. But I'm still dropping. Got him looking like James Harden at the awards. Back to you, I'm so into you. For real, bread like I'm clean to you. If you were 10, I add 10 to you. They be mad when I 10 to you. That's what the bay like. Call me Buffy, cause that's what I slay like. These, I send them like it's daylight. These, wanna know what it's like. What it's like, yo, what it's like, yo. They wanna know what it's like, yo. All this ice is like snow. Get kimonos and let's fly to Tokyo. Pretty, pretty, please, baby. Won't you pop this for me?
I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero Dale, get my baby 35.
Hey, this that Eastside Johnny Big Redemption like. Know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.